Okay, Rock, I am recording the screen. I have it set to auto exposure right now. And let's see, where do I want to put the target? If I put the target by the sun, it gets dark. If I put the target away from the sun, it gets light. So if I put the target at the zenith, that's what we get. So let me turn auto exposure off. Okay, there it is. So you can see this is gain one, exposure is 0.127 milliseconds. Let me increase the exposure slightly. Now you can see, let me go to 0.7 milliseconds. 0.7 milliseconds, you can see the what happened there. See, there's the side of the observatory, telephone pole. Which way is north? I'm trying to figure north. The telephone pole is to the southeast. So let me turn the camera a little bit. To the southeast, observatory, north. I think I have the orientation right now. The handle is pointed towards south. Okay. So right now I have 0.127. Okay, the sun is up in the northwest. The dome is to the northeast. Telephone pole is in the southeast, and that big oak tree is to the due south. So the orientation is correct right now. Okay. So let me go at a little bit longer exposure, maybe. Quarter second, 0.25 milliseconds. A quarter of a millisecond. Okay, so what else can I show? Bit depth is 8, white balance just did a white balance. Turn white balance off. There's white balance. Color adjustments is to default. Frame rate is low. Color is, there's grayscale. And there is color. Okay. Back in color mode. I got the region of interest selected, and I'm at 82% zoom right now. Digital bending is 1. Histogram, you can see it. So what's left? Dark black level is 0. Sharpness is off. What happens when I increase sharpness? Like 250% sharpness right now. Auto exposure. Let's go to maximum sharpness, 500. Auto exposure. That's maximum sharpness. Down to minimum sharpness. Okay. Can always go to a negative. Back to positive. And then we can zoom in. That's control. Put this down in the side, and the exposure adjusts for the horizon. There it adjusts for the dome. Put it in the center. Fit to width. There's a fit to width. So it looks like this may have promise for an all-sky camera. We just have to figure out how to mount it and keep it dry.